Hello friends, today we are meeting again with a new topic, and the topic is empowerment concept, meaning, need and indicators of women empowerment. Before that, a brief introduction about myself. Myself is Sudeshna Lahiri. I come from Department of Education, University of Calcutta, and I'm associate professor over there. So once again, welcome to NIOS DLED program with a new topic, and it is very interesting and important. So the definition of women empowerment, the concept of women empowerment appears to be the outcome of several important critics and debates generated by women movement throughout the world, and particularly by the third world feminists. The verbal definition of empowerment is related to the word power. In English, the concept leans on its original meaning of investment with legal power, permission to act for some specific goal or purpose. The new meaning of the concept empowerment, and especially women empowerment, includes mainly references to power that develops and is acquired. People are managing to gain more control over their lives, either by themselves or with the help of others. Empowerment. In a sentence, if we talk about empowerment, we have a definition, and that is, empowerment is an active, multidimensional process which enables women to realize their full identity and powers in all spheres of life. Women empowerment. It is the awareness building about women's situation, discrimination and rights and opportunities as a step towards gender equality. Collective awareness building provides a sense of group identity and the power of working as a group. So gender empowerment and women empowerment is to aware of women about its situation, status and discrimination she is going through, and for this discrimination she is having some kind of rights given by the society and also the government, and there are many opportunities she could take help of to overcome all kind of discrimination and differential treatments. Empowerment is also capacity building and skills development, especially the ability to plan, make decisions, organize, manage and carry out activities to deal with people and institutions in the world around them. Women empowerment is also the participation and greater control and decision making power in the home, community and society, and also personal and professional front. Women empowerment is the action to bring about greater equality between men and women. The meaning of women empowerment, once again, women empowerment is a social process that neutralizes women's operations. The actions that follow women's empowerment resolve to develop their potential and to take broader roles in community and societal activities. Women empowerment is synonymous with the achievement of equality and equal-mindedness in society. Women empowerment will result in traditional women values being more respected in society at large. Women empowerment is a base for human liberation and empowerment for all. Women empowerment will bring more balance to the male value hierarchies in current traditional and modern society. So why do we need this women empowerment at all? So need for women empowerment. Women have been relegated to the margins in spite of the fact that they are numerically half of the world's population. The visible achievement of women as a teachers, doctors, pilots, politicians and explorers, etc., have demolished the patriarchal notions of confining women's role in home and hearth. The society, which is patriarchal and patrilinear, decides the woman should be at home, and her boundaries are determined by the society. And the profession is also decided by the society, which could suit her. When women empowerment is needed because the honor killing epidemic needs to be addressed. Child marriages take away the childhoods of little girls and push them into the responsibility of married life, and she is reduced to an object. Female genital mutilation is happening till date and is practiced on girls as young as 5 months old. Girls have fewer opportunities to receive an education in developing countries due to limited resources and gender parities. Every day in newspaper, we read the stories how the girls are struggling with the family and the immediate society to get admission into school and for higher education. And girls are suffering from a pipeline leakage, where at every level of primary, secondary, higher secondary and higher education, there is a leakage of enrollment of girls. Women experience terror when walking alone under the moon, and in some places even under the sun. Women are still defined by their looks. Women are pressured by media and the beauty industry to have skinny bodies and flawless faces. Imagine a woman is an object to be adorned, and the media and the society is working towards it to make the women to reduce to an object itself. Financial empowerment of women spurs economic growth within a country. If women are empowered, that frees men from mounting pressure to be the primary bread earner. They should understand that. Now, what are the indicators of women empowerment? There are certain indicators which determine that there are women empowerment and the country is moving towards a women empowerment. The draft country paper India for the 4th World Conference on Women, and it occurred in Beijing, China in 1995. The conference proposed qualitative and quantitative indicators for evaluating the women empowerment. The qualitative indicators of women empowerments, there are many indicators, but we will discuss few of them. And they are increase in self-esteem, individual and collective confidence of women. Articulation on women's health, nutrition, reproductive rights, legal rights, literacy and so on, depending on the program. Changing volume in personal leisure time and time for child care for women, because she doesn't have any me time. Changing roles and responsibility in family and in community, how with the time she is changing her role and society is also deciding her changing role. Just a cooking in the house to a economic contributor in the family. Changing nature and types of violence against women. These are all our indicators of women empowerment. How empowered is women becoming over the time? Social norms and milieu against women. Changing women participation in public diaspora. Negotiation by women in domestic, personal and professional responsibility. Access to and ability to gather information and knowledge. Qualitative indicators. So among qualitative indicators, there are a few more to discuss. Cohesive and articulate women's groups, organizations at different political and geographical levels. Changes in social attitudes among us, the community members, towards discrimination against women and the girl child, awareness and recognition of women's economic contribution within and outside the household, women's decision and making over the kind of work she is doing. Is her income and expenditure is in her control, or is she still subservient to male members? Even she is earning, but she doesn't have a single penny for herself. And there are few more. For example, quantitative indicators of women empowerment, because previous to that we have discussed a list of qualitative indicators. Now we are discussing the quantitative indicators of women empowerment. So they may be demographic details in frequencies, means and percentages, which are in numbers, in numerals. For example, maternal or mortality rates, fertility rates, sex ratio, life expectancy at birth, average age of marriage. These are all quantitative indicators. So while we are discussing about some of the qualitative indicators with some quantitative indicators, there are few more quantitative indicators to discuss. For example, women participating in policy making bodies and programs, extent of access to and control over community resources, government scheme and services. These all are quantitative indicators. Nutritional level participation in labor force, male and female literacy levels, primary, secondary and adult literacy, including enrollment and retention rates. Participation in politics and House of Parliaments. So these all are quantitative. In addition of some of the qualitative indicators we have discussed earlier. Now, what are the role of women in empowering herself? So the status of women could be improved by women themselves and nobody else. In this age of science and technology, why the women should be left behind in comparison to men? She contributes to almost half of the population of the world. So how could we think about a world and its progression when one half is lagging far behind? The popular UNESCO slogan, educate a man and you educate an individual, educate a woman and you educate a family, is the most appropriate in today's scenario. Women will have to empower themselves from below in order to compel the government to empower them. So it's not that one of the economical strata they should empower themselves. It should be below, right below in the society, the most lower tier of the society and economic strata. The women should be empowered from that, the below most strata. Education can play a vital role in bringing about the required behavioral changes among women and make them well educated and equipped in terms of knowledge, competence and capacity to deal with different problems. So today we have discussed that what is women empowerment, and we know that it is very important that empowering a woman. Beside that, a society cannot progress, a nation cannot progress, a government cannot progress. And education is the medium, a vehicle through which a woman can be empowered. Most importantly, the girl child, they face a high attrition rate in school education. A very few lucky of them could make out in higher education. Especially since 1970s, the representation of women is little fair in higher education. But before that, the representation of women in higher education was very poor. Especially in some of the professional courses, the women representation is very skewed. We hardly find a woman, or the representation is so slim that these courses are termed as masculine courses or vocation and program. And that is how the women empowerment face a handicap. They fail to understand that this vocation and this educational course is not for me, it's for my male counterpart. So it is important that the women should be given the vacancy, women should be given a privilege to be educated in whatever field she likes to be. And there are certain indicators we should understand that which determines whether the empowerment growth is happening in the country, in the society or not. For example, whether there is any change in mortality rate or fertility rate or the sex ratio, the representation of women in the parliament, in panchayat, representation of women in higher education, representation of women in different plan programs, in school management committee, and representation of women in different vocation and every walk of life. So today we have discussed the women empowerment, its need, its indicator, its important and its concept. We will meet again with a new topic in a new session. Thank you.